Hey everyone, I'm about to chat with Jesse Wegner of the reggae band The Agrolites about their new album, Reggae Now, their awesome new video for Pound for Pound, and the current tour with the Long Beach Dub All-Stars. Can you start by introducing yourself?
Sure. Am I getting recorded?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'm Jesse Wagner, and I'm the singer, guitar player of the Agrolites.
Your new album, Reggae Now, came out a couple weeks ago. Can you tell me about the album and your time in the studio?
Tell about the what in the studio?
Can you tell me about the album and your time in the studio?
Yeah, well, we really had no time frame. We just kind of did it on our own time. Our organ player, Roger Rivas, had built a studio at his house. We took a few years off from touring. We did, we would do weekend tours, a little 40 runs here and there. And we'd go to Europe once a year. But as far as touring 250, 300 days a year like we used to, took a break from that. So we can all do our own stuff. So in that time off, whenever we find the time to get together, we would do so. We recorded, me and Roger would get together a lot, demo tracks, write songs together, just sit down at a, you know, at somebody's house and just jot things down on paper and stuff like that. We got the full band together to track the rhythms, the full album. That only took a day. We did all that in one day. And then as far as overdubs and, you know, overdubbing vocals and horn lines and things, horn lines, that was just a few hours here and there. I think maybe the full amount of time that we actually spent recording the record was, I don't know, maybe 15 hours, 15 to 20 hours tops.
It's been about 8 years since your last record came out. Why such a big gap between albums, and did you do anything different this time?
It's like I said before, everybody kind of needed a break for a while. We were together touring 250 plus, you know, to 300 days a year for about 12 years straight. And everybody kind of wanted to get back to their own personal lives and do their own thing. A few of us started doing different side project bands, you know. Roger built the studio, so that's why it's been a long time since our last album release. And I think what made this one special is not being pressured to come out with something every single year, you know, to keep the momentum going on tour. It just kind of happened on our own time, which made things easy.
Last week you released a video for Pound for Pound. I think it came out really awesome. How did the idea for the concept come about?
Pound for Pound, the idea of it, I think that's one of the first tunes I wrote lyrics for on the new record. And the lyrics are pretty self-explainable. It's just kind of saying, you know, here we are, we're back, this is where we've been, we're ready to go, and like the chorus states, you know, it's going to be strong if you wait that long for the aggro sound, pound for pound will make you come around, and it's just kind of like a lot of those old reggae tunes back in the late 60s, that song's like inspired a lot by Clancy Eccles and Derek Morgan, and a lot of those Derek Morgan skinhead reggae tunes and Clancy Eccles tunes were kind of like bragging and boasting about who they were, what they were all about, you know, being at the top. So that's kind of taking a little tip of the hat, you know, towards those old musicians from the late 1960s, but telling our story with it, you know.
Was that your favorite song to record on the album, or was there another one that was your favorite and why?
We had a lot of fun recording a song called Shadow Walk. We were big fans of Steve Perry and the Upsetters. And there's an album called Return of Super 8 that all of us enjoy a lot. And our friend, who's now our guitar player, Chris Brennan, had a lot of old studio gear that Lee Perry would use specifically for that record and a lot of other records in that era. There's a studio called Black Ark. So kind of going for that vibe and that sound and watching Chris Brennan dub out that tune. That was a lot of fun because we never really approached that to the extreme of what we did on this record. So I would say Shadow Walk was a lot of fun. Another song called Love Me Tonight, where we got to have Alex Dazaire and Destin Berry of Hepcat. Both of them got to sing vocals with me, and those guys have been like my mentors. That whole band, Hepcat, has been like the band that basically got me into the old school ska, rocksteady, reggae music. So having them was a huge honor. So spending a day with them tracking vocals was also an amazing experience.
Currently you're out on the road with the Long Beach Dub All-Stars. How has the tour been so far, and how do you feel your fans are receiving the new music?
Tour's been great. We've been good friends with those guys forever. I mean, we've known them close to 20 years already, both bands being from Los Angeles areas. And yeah, it's like being on tour with family. They're just great people, fit us really well. And we like spending time with each other. Our organ player Roger is actually in both bands, so that's a lot of fun for him. And as far as the crowd, I think every night is, I mean, when it goes for any tour that the Acolytes do, the motto is to go out there and, you know, give them your best and win over that audience, no matter what style of music the headliner band plays. It's certainly exactly what we do in the Rock House, Stars, and Kid. Their fans, from what I've noticed so far, have been very responsive and very open-minded to our music. They appreciate it, so it's a lot better than a lot of the tours that we've done in the past. This one's definitely been a very receptive crowd of people.
Are there any other tours in the works for this year that you're allowed to talk about?
Sure. Yeah. We're in Japan for a week in September. I don't know the exact dates. It's somewhere within the week of September 14th through like 17th or so. And we've only been to Japan for one day only. That's it, one night we spent in Japan. So we're excited to at least do a tour. Coming this November, we're going to do a full month throughout Europe, which will be mostly like Spain, Germany, France, Switzerland, Austria, and a few other places, the UK possibly. And that's going to be about it for this year. We're probably going to wrap things up with some holiday tour leading into New Year's Eve. And that's it, yeah, for this year. We're pretty much going to be busy for the rest of the year, so we're all excited about that.
What has been the greatest memory so far in your career?
Oh, geez, that's a crazy question, because I don't have a memory anymore after all. As a teenager, you have a list of all the people that you'd love to meet, you know, and play with. And looking back at it, you know, just like a few weeks ago, actually, I went down memory lane because me and my wife made a move. We moved places, and I found an old box with like a journal in it of all these. Where you want to be in 30 years or whatever, you know, it's like me as a teenager. And we'll be talking about how I'd love to meet Prince Buster and Derek Morgan and Phyllis Dillon and many other old school Jamaican artists. And then thinking about it, and it's like, wow, over the last 30 years, that
that's when I've really done 20 years at least as a musician. Might not ever have made it, you know, rock star famous, but definitely in the world of what we play and what we do, I'm 100% satisfied and humbled and honored to be able to have accomplished what I've done with myself and with this band, the Agrolites, where the Agrolites have taken us.
Since forming the band in 2002, how do you feel the music scene has changed and where do you see it heading in the future?
It's changed a lot. It's gone up and down as far as the ska scene in general. I mean, we don't play ska. A lot of people think we play ska, but we don't. We play reggae. We call it dirty reggae, but we're influenced by like 69, 70, 71 era reggae. But, you know, we melt into that ska scene, and if that's what you're referring to, you know, it's been hit or miss. There was a long time it was extremely popular and really big, and then for a good decade or so it was the dorky thing, you know, the young kids. A lot of kids got into screamo and emo, and we've done some Warped Tours where it was like, you know, you wouldn't even hear the word ska being mentioned on the Warped Tour except for a handful of bands, when at one time ska and punk was like the big thing on the Warped Tour. You know, and now thanks to groups like the Interrupters carrying the flag of ska, they're bringing a lot of old groups back, like Safe Ferris is coming back, and a lot of other groups are coming out with new albums. The Agrolites haven't had an album. It just seems like 2019 is the right time to where I see the ska reggae scene starting to get popular and blow up again, you know?
Yeah.
It seems like everything from the, you know, early to mid-90s was, I guess that's just how everything goes. Everything goes in waves where it's like when I was a teenager, anything from like the 1970s was like cool, you know, like the whole, that movie, Dazed and Confused came out, the whole like hippie thing and that whole thing got cool. And now it seems like, you know, 30 years ago was the early 90s, so kids are all into like the 90s things, you know, 90s clothes, and Nintendo, things from the 90s, so, you know, that third wave ska definitely played a big part in the 90s, so I think it's making its comeback again, and bringing a lot of bands with it, you know?
Yeah.
As far as the style that we're influenced by, old skinhead reggae and all that, that's always been an underground thing. I kind of have a feeling that it always will be an underground thing. It's never lost its momentum to the level that it got. It's always been popular with the working class and the punk rockers, and it's kind of held its ground as far as what it's been. But it still yet hasn't become anything, you know, hugely mainstream. I think the thing that got it closest to mainstream would be the early Bob Marley and the Wailers recordings, you know.
Do you have anything else you'd like to add or tell your fans?
Let me think about this. Yeah, listen to reggae. If you like what you hear nowadays, you know, open your mind and dig into it, you know. If you're listening to a certain band right now, learn about the band, learn about what the band is inspired by, because you might find yourself in a whole new world of music that you've never known you'd be listening to. So, I mean, don't just stop at the one band. Listen to band things the bands are inspired by. Listen to interviews that the bands make. When they name drop things that they love or you know, groups that got them into what they play, check out those groups, because, like I said, it might lead you into a whole new world of something else, you know. And buy all the Agrolite records that you can.
Where can your fans find you online?
Agro reggae.com. agroreggae.com. We're also on Instagram @TheAgrolites, and we're also on Facebook as just TheAgrolites. You can also find our album and lots of our merchandise at piratespressrecords.com, which is our record label. So, yeah, those few links should be good heads. start. Find us on YouTube, Spotify, all those too.
Thank you so much for taking the time to chat with me today.
You're welcome. Thank you for taking the interview.
Thank you to Jesse Wagner for chatting with me today. Be sure to check out the Agrolites, their new album Reggae Now, and head out to a show on their tour with the Long Beach Dub All-Stars. For more information on the band, head over to www.agroreggae.com.